And for more now on the Jason Collins story, I'm joined by LZ Granderson, a sports writer and columnist for ESPN and a CNN contributor. Well, specifically for our non-sports fans, why was this taken so long in pro sports, and why is it a big deal now?
One of the reasons why it's taking so long in professional sports is because there's this sense of the locker room that it isn't an environment in which an openly gay male player would feel safe, that if he came out, that his job would be in jeopardy, that his health could be at risk, especially if he's playing a collision sport like football or hockey, or that a team wouldn't sign him or would cut him or waive him if he's playing football. So the threat of your livelihood and the threat of the health for many, many years was the reason why athletes were so hesitant to come out. And as far as it being a big deal now, I would like to, it's a big deal in the sense that it's the first player, but when you look at the arc of the LGBT movement and where we are right now, I'm not sure if it's as big of a deal as perhaps what's going on in the Supreme Court right now with the Defense of Marriage Act. In other words, the movement has progressed to a certain point in which the laws that are being addressed are affecting a much larger group of people than perhaps the symbolism of one player coming out in the NBA.
You're saying the movement in the larger culture is beyond where sports is, perhaps. What kind of reaction is this getting so far in the world of sports, and what kind of reaction might you expect later on in the locker room?
Well, you know, Jason's a free agent, so right now he doesn't have a particular locker room to report to. And that is the piece of the puzzle that we're all waiting for, if you will. Everyone that's been tweeting thus far, for the most part, have been very supportive. It's my understanding that President Obama recently called Jason Collins and congratulated him. We know Michelle Obama tweeted that we've got your back. Numerous players, including Kobe Bryant and Steve Nash, have all tweeted in support of Jason. But at the end of the day, where we are in this conversation will be determined about whether or not Jason is re-signed. If he goes into a locker room, if he is signed as an openly gay player, then I think we know where we are. If he's not signed, we have much more questions that needs to be asked as well as answered. Was he not signed because he's openly gay? Was he not signed because he's not a particularly great player, because he's 34? A lot of other questions will be out there that have to be answered.
What is your sense of where things stand in other sports? Beyond basketball, football, for example, a famously macho environment, right?
Well, you know, I'm an openly gay man. I like to think of myself as fairly macho. So I don't think one's sexual orientation.
I certainly didn't mean that. I just meant the reputation.
No. Well, I know, and you know, and people usually preface the conversation about professional sports about it being this really macho environment, when the truth of the matter is that, you know, whatever we deem as stereotypically macho, the male athletes that have come out thus far in the professional sports all fit that bill. Mm-hmm. John Amici played a big power forward position. I would think that would be pretty macho. He's a big, strong guy. Before him, Dave Coppé was a killer on the field, pretty macho guy. So I think part of this conversation is perhaps reframing the way we think about it in its entirety, looking at it perhaps through a different paradigm. So that's the reason why I gave a little pushback.
I take the point. Well taken. But so what is the situation then in other sports? Is there similar to what you see in basketball?
I do know that all the leagues have worked with or are still working with some national organization addressing homophobia in sports. You know, the NBA has been working with the Gay, Lesbian, Straight Education Network for years prior to Jason Collins coming out, prior to Kobe Bryant being fined last year for uttering a gay slur inadvertently on television. The NFL has been working with an organization to try to address homophobia in sports. The NHL, a couple of weeks ago, announced working with an organization to make things better for an openly gay athlete in this sport. So I would think that, at least from an executive level, a lot has been done to address this issue and to make things more comfortable or more tolerant for an openly gay player to exist in the locker room. But with that being said, no locker room has what has happened in the NBA. And if Jason is re-signed, the other leagues have a lot of catching up to do.
All right, LZ Granderson, ESPN columnist, thanks so much.
Hey, thank you.
And online, we have reaction from athletes from the NBA and other major sports leagues. That's on our rundown.